to start off with reading and translating that to a violin, let's dive right into the basics. First of all, you'll see the staff. The staff has five lines in it, and this is where we place the notes. If we place a note higher in the staff, it's going to sound higher. Place the note a little bit lower, it's going to sound lower. That is the pitch. At the beginning of each staff, you'll see a clef. We have a treble clef, you have alto clef, and also a bass clef. The bass clef will be for celli and double basses. The alto clef is used by violas, and we violinists, we use the treble clef. At the beginning of a staff, you'll also see the time signature. Here you see four quarters. If you look at the bottom number, that is the count. In this case, a quarter is the count. But don't worry, we'll explain it all when it comes. The top number will say how many counts are in a bar. So in this case, we have four counts in a bar, so we count till four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. And as you can see, the bars are divided with bar lines. This makes it easy for us to see where the four counts end and where the new four counts start again. We also have an end bar. This means we've come to the end of a song. Now we've come to the notes. I just explained that the position of a note in a staff determines how high or how low the note sounds, the pitch. But we can also write a note value. That means how long will that note last. Long notes, short notes, and with those we'll get a sort of rhythm, the melody. So let me take you through that. First of all, we have a whole note. And if we saw that the count would be the quarter note, we have four counts in this whole note. We have a half note. That would mean, with the time signature we have, that there are two counts in the half note. Now we get the closed note. And that is the quarter note. Here I'll show you the division of the notes. First of all, the whole note. And we can fit in two half notes in a whole note. You can see four quarter notes in the whole note. And here we see eighth notes. And here you can also see we can write them separate. Or we can beam them, like that. And of course, 16th notes. This is how you can divide the notes. A melody will always be a combination of note values and note pitches. Okay, now let's see how the notes written in the staff correspond with the correct positions on the violin. First of all, I'll take the highest string. The highest string is the E string, and this is placed at this position in the staff. This is the highest open string. If I place my first finger on the string, we have F sharp. This is what we call the note. It's got a name. One note higher. Okay? Now, you can see the position in the staff. The first one was under the first line. This note is on top of the top line in the staff. That corresponds with the first finger on the E string. One note higher, that'll be above the top line in the staff. That is the second finger on the E string. You see, it goes higher from the E string. I'm gonna place one note higher on the top line, higher, so a higher note. And one more time, higher is gonna be above the top line in the staff. That's the second finger on the E string. So that's how you recognize the pitch in the staff corresponding with which finger on which string. Okay, let's take you to the A string. The A string is scored here at this position. So you can remember you have the middle line and the A string is under the middle line. That is the open A string. If I place the note on top of the middle line, so it's one position higher, that's the first finger on the A string. If I go one position higher, I go above the middle line. I'm placing the note here, and that is the second finger on the A string. That's it. One higher would be the third. We're not working with the third yet in the beginning. It's going to come a little bit later in the course. But to make reading a little bit easier, I'm just working with two fingers for the next exercises. So it's easier to recognize them as well. Okay, going to the D string. The D string is under the bottom line. The note placed under the bottom line in the staff, that is the open D string. So if you see the note written down under the bottom line of the staff, at this position, it's the open D string. One position higher will be on the bottom line. That's going to be the first finger on the D string. One position higher, it's going to be above the bottom line. And that is the second finger on the D string. Okay. And now we go to the G string. And this will exceed the range of the five staff lines. So we need help lines there, ledger lines. These are going to help us define where is this note scored. It's the lowest, so it's going to be low, even lower than the staff itself. Two help lines, two ledger lines are going to give us this position, and that's the open string. Okay? If we go one step higher, it's going to be on that second help line, the second ledger line. If you see this note at this position, it's the first finger on the G string. And now, second finger on the G string, we write it down at this point. So those are the positions on the violin that correspond with the note pitches in the staff. Now, if you want to learn to read, I would advise you to learn to recognize the positions in the staff. And this is going to make your reading very easy. If you learn this right, learning the letters of the alphabet, and then you can read the words. Well, this is exactly the same. You can always find a reference in book one, in lesson one. And those are found below the videos on the website, these black buttons, download buttons. There you get the pages, and on those pages you'll find the reference notes. So you can learn that there and always know what and where you're playing. Okay, now you would know where is the A in the staff. The open A string. First finger. Second finger. Okay, let me give you an example. I'm going to play quarter notes, and I'm going to use these three pitches. The open string, the first finger, and the second finger. Okay, look how this is scored. Can you see it? If I would do something similar on the D string, here's the D pitch. First finger on the and second finger above. Okay, I can play half notes. Quarter. One, two, three, four. That's it. Now I used the different pitches and the different note values. And I did this in the four-quarter time signature. So each bar, as you could see, would have four counts in them. There can be two half notes, one whole note, maybe even eighth notes, or a combination of both. Now, this is what we're going to work with in the first lessons in the Creative Violin method. So I hope now you understand how it works with the reading. So let's try that in the next exercise, 1, A, B, C, and D. From all open strings, the first fingers and the second fingers.